In this session, we will apply pumping lemma to prove that the perfect scale language is not a regular language. Let's start the session. So in case of pumping lemma, let L be a regular language recognized by a finite automata with n states. Then if we will consider any string w belongs to the language with length greater than equal to n, then w can be divided into three parts x, y and z, with the condition that the length of y is greater than 0 and length of xy is less than equal to n, then xy ki power I z will always belongs to the language for I is greater than equal to 0. It means we can able to pump y a number of times. To prove a language is non-regular using pumping lemma, initially we will assume that the given language is a regular one. If a language is regular one, we can able to design a DFA with n states. Now if you will consider any string w belongs to the language with the length of w is greater than equal to n, then according to pumping lemma, we can able to divide w into three parts x, y and z with the condition that the length of y is greater than 0 and length of xy is less than equal to n. And if we will prove that x, y ki power I, z does not belongs to L for any I greater than equal to 0, we can say that the given language is non-regular. Now let's assume the given language is perfect scale language. It means L is 0 power m square, where m can be greater than equal to 0. And this language will consist of this string null, 0, 40, 90, 160 and so on. So initially we will assume that the given language is regular one. So we will assume L is a regular language and we can able to design a DFA with n states. Now we will consider a string w belongs to the language such that length of w is greater than equal to n. For simplicity, we will take w is 0 n square. So length of w is n square and it is greater than equal to n. Now we will divide w into three parts x, y and z with the condition that length of y is greater than 0 and length of xy is less than equal to n. From these two conditions, we can able to find out that minimum length of y is 1, and if x is null, y length is less than equal to n, so maximum length of y can be n. Now in the third step, we will prove that x, y square z does not belongs to the language. The length of x, y square z is length of x, y, z and length of y, and length of x, y, z is nothing. It will be equal to n square. And minimum length of y is 1, so it can be 1 or greater than 1 but less than equal to n, so it is always greater than n square. It means length of x, y square z is always greater than n square. Length of x, y square z will be equal to x, y, z plus length of y, and x, y square z length is n square, and the maximum length of y can be n, and it is always less than n square plus 2n plus 1, which is equal to n plus 1 square. So we can say that length of x, y square z lies between n square and n plus 1 square. But we can easily able to say that there is no perfect square exists between n square and n plus 1 square. So x, y square z length is not a perfect square. What it means, it does not belongs to the language. So we can say L is a non-regular language. Thanks for watching this session.